let's go ahead with the calculation for mold filling time. So I will be deriving two formulas. The first one over here will be top filling, when we are going to pour the material from the top. In the second case, we are going to pour the material from sidewards. So over here also, effectively, we are going to pour it from the top, but actually when it is going to enter in the mold, it is entering from sidewards. So let's start with this. There is simple things we need to remember. The HT is the total height. H2 is the height from point 2 to point 3. So I have mentioned 3 points. One is the layer at which the metal is poured. So that is the free surface of the basin. HC is the height, HC, which is between 1 and 2. PO is the external pressure or atmospheric pressure. And 3 is where the gates enter, or from where the cast actually starts. So there are three locations with us, and we are going to apply Bernoulli's equation between 1 and 3. So that's what I have written, P1, V1 terms and HT term. Over here at the location 3, the height is 0. So that's what I'm taking as the reference. All the heights are with respect to the point 3. So that's why point 3 has the height as 0. P1 and P3 are going to be P atmospheric, because this is also open to atmosphere. This is level 3 is also open to atmosphere. And V1 will be 0. So it approximately, when we are going to pour the material and it is going to get inside the cast from there, this level is not going to very much. We'll keep on pouring until all the corners are filled up. So in that case, the velocity at V at position 1 is going to be almost equal to 0. The V3 velocity will be 2GH3, that is HT, that is because of the gravity driven flow, the velocity will increase as the metal reaches at this location 3. So that is because directly coming from V square minus U square is equal to 2AS, right? So in this case, VG means the velocity at the gate will be 2GHT, and hence the mold filling time will be T, time to fill the mold, equal to, in the numerator, it is the total volume of the mold which needs to be filled with the metal. In the denominator, we have the area of the gate, which is the area over here, and velocity at the gate, which is what I have derived earlier. So that's how the mold filling time can be derived in case of top filling. This is an important concept, but we'll go to this a bit later. So let's go ahead with the side filling. Side filling is a bit difficult, so I'll take that in the next video. Fine. Thank you.